Make sure I'm recording. Awesome. Well, as promised, you know, I'm very glad that Annapurna is Annapurna Interactive Art didn't work. I think they did a film once. May was Sorry to Bother You, which I enjoyed that film. But anyway, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time zone you're in. Welcome to I Am Dead. I know how that sounds. But yeah, I Am Dead walkthrough. Let's get started. Okay, so the beauty of this walkthrough is I don't have to actually say a lot, so I can actually be silent for a while, and everyone would be okay with it because it's the walkthrough that nobody's really going to be looking at, but I'll watch or have as like background noise if I'm studying or just like, you know, just chilling and all that. So, of course, leave a like, comment, or subscribe. As I talked about, we're going to be focusing on like a marathon, focusing on iSection games I currently own, and that's going to be the major focus. So, yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. If we get through the iSection of the games very fast, then we'll move on to the J, and there's not a lot in the J section, so maybe we can possibly get to the K, optimistically, but I highly doubt it. I feel like we're going to just be able to do one letter, and that's pretty much it. Okay, so that's pretty much the gist of today. Really, 1 week I'm going to just do a marathon and be like, I'm going to do a marathon of games and just pretty much do every alphabet order just to finish it out one day. But it'll come eventually. Anyway, go ahead and sell it now.
In the last summer, before our GCSEs, Val and me spent a lot of time together, usually wondering how we could get our hands on something to drink. No one on this stupid little island would serve us, though. In the last summer, before our GCSEs, Val and me spent a lot...
No one on this stupid little island would serve us, though.
I spent the summer of 83 with Henry Outram, Laird of Shelmiston, in his grand hall working on a new piece. It was supposed to be about the volcano, but once I arrived, I found myself particularly taken by all the veils around the island. Henry was a delightful host, always excited to have us bright young artists around, and always ready with a charming question or a fortifying glass of something. His daughter, I think her name was Mallory or Valerie or something, was usually outside roaming the grounds. Henry said she was discovering herself and learning self-reliance through independent play.
She seemed feral to me. One day, I came across the perfect finishing touch to my sculptural masterpiece, but it turned out to belong to the wretched child. I tried to explain to her why I needed it, but she snatched it away and walked off. I went to Henry, thinking he could make her give me the boat, but to my astonishment, Henry told me it was up to her if she wanted to give it to me. Henry called his daughter and we all talked about it. When Henry suggested that maybe I could buy the boat, her little eyes lit up. It cost me £200 for that little wooden boat, but it was worth it.
Ah, Henry was a good dad at heart, caring about Val's feelings and treating her like a grown-up even when she was little. Partly how she became so independent, I reckon. I know it was tough on him, but they both turned out pretty well.
In the last summer, before our GCSEs, Val and me spent a lot of time together, usually wondering how we could get our hands on something to drink. No one on this stupid little island would serve us, though. One day, we were hanging around on the allotments near the quay, when we spotted something. And so, later that night, we went into the woods behind Val's house to drink it, sitting on top of that ancient stone that they say protects the island. But there was no way we were going to get through it all, so we decided to bury the rest. A few weeks later, we went to dig it up again, but couldn't remember where we'd dug the hole.
There is so much of our history buried on this island. Stories everywhere, right under your feet.
Can't get enough gloves. I stole a farmer's glove. I stole a fisherman's glove. I saw that girl out in my woods riding that strange bumpy beast around again. She really seemed to love that awful creature. This was an opportunity I wasn't going to miss. Lovely gloves.
I always did suspect there might be something in those rumors about camels on the island. All that time, and Val never let on. Bless you, Val.
After my wife Penny's death, I struggled to find ways to spend time with my daughter. It had hit us both hard, but, you know, stiff upper lip and all that. I always found it best to keep busy. Looking for something we could do together, I bought Valerie a set of paints. But she never even opened them. I was cross at first, but asked myself, what would Penny do? So I decided to let it go. Then one day I managed to talk her into coming into the park with me to paint some of the nature she loves so much. She wasn't very enthusiastic, but agreed to give it a try. It was a disaster. Valerie simply didn't have the temperament for painting. She had a huge silly tantrum and threw all the paints away. I told her I wasn't having this kind of childish behavior. And I told her to stay in her room until she had calmed down. I wished Penny was still with us. She would have known what to do with the child. Mm.
Very hard, that, to lose a parent. It was never going to be easy after her mum died, but he always did seem distracted with his fancy art projects.
Not this guy.
Hello? Ready for some fun?
Hello.
I'm Mr. Whitstable. Welcome to Mr. Whitstable's riddle game.
Morris, we don't have time for this. Let's get back to work.
Mr. Whitstable just wants you to enjoy yourself, solve my riddles, and achieve true happiness.
Well, these do seem kind of fun.
Whatever, Morris.
Oh, Sparky. Okay, Mr. Whitstable, what do I have to do?
Hooray! Just select one of my fiendish riddles, then go off and find the object it's referring to. Easy. Well, actually, they're really hard.
Ha! Oh, we got this. Come on, Sparky.
Thank you.
After my wife Penny's death, I struggled to find ways. Looking for something we could do together, I bought Valerie's. Then one day I managed to talk.
It was a disaster.
I told her I wasn't having this.
Thank you.
After my wife Penny's death, I struggled to find work. Looking for something we could do together, I bought... Then one day I managed to talk...
It was a disaster.
I told her I wasn't having this...
Thank you.